everyone. For this data jam, I invited my colleague Rex to share with us some really cool tricks about how to use pre-selected filters to find new data products on data.census.gov. He's also going to show us how to use table IDs to find a table that you like and want to see it again. Let's check it out.
Hi, my name is Rex. In this data jam, I'll show you how to locate new tables while keeping your filters in data.census.gov. Let's start by using advanced search. I want to search for tables on income, so I'll choose topics, income and poverty, income and earnings, and then check the box next to income, households, families, individuals. And I want it for 6 states, so I'll select geography and state. Let's choose Arkansas, Delaware, Idaho, Michigan, New Jersey, and Rhode Island. Now that I have all my filters selected, I'll hit the search button to see what tables are returned. Let's click on S1901, income in the past 12 months. Once I've gotten the data I need from this table, let's say that I want to search for another table, S1701, poverty status in the past 12 months. But I want to make sure that I keep the geographies that I selected. In this case, the states of Arkansas, Delaware, Idaho, Michigan, New Jersey, and Rhode Island. To do this, I'm going to move up to the search bar at the top of the page and click on it. When I do that, I have an empty search bar that I could use, as well as an advanced search button. As a developing site, our single search bar and our advanced search are not integrated. So if you were to type in the table ID here, it would clear out your advanced search, including the geographies, and only show you S1701 for the US. We want the advanced search button, so I'm going to click on that to open the advanced search pane back up. Notice that this brings up the same advanced search pane from earlier, with all the filters already selected. I want to search for table S1701, though I am going to click on the X next to income, households, families, and individuals to remove it from the filters, leaving 6 geographies behind. If I don't remove this from the selected filters, it will conflict with the new filters that I select, and I may not get any data returned to me. Now that I've removed income filter, I'm going to move up to the top search bar and type in S1701. You definitely want to make sure that you choose the first search bar, which allows for a text search, otherwise this won't work. Now that I have entered S1701, I'm going to hit the search button. This will bring up a single table, S1701. Click on it to open to the full view. Note that we have data for all the states that we selected earlier. Now, let's say that I want to find tables on another topic, health insurance, but I don't have the table ID is handy. Not to worry. We can use the same method to search for topics instead of table IDs. So let's go back to the search bar and hit advanced search button. Notice that all our geography filters are still selected. Move to the top search bar and delete S1701. Replace it with health insurance. Then hit the search button. This time, we get a return of 302 tables for our combination of health insurance topic and the 6 state geographies. You can use this method of searching using the advanced search button as many times as you want. I hope you found this data gem helpful. Thank you.
Thank you, Rex, for sharing your knowledge with us. I hope you guys enjoy. For more videos like this, visit census.gov/academy and subscribe. Thank you.